The ILEA, who run over 1,000 schools in inner London, believe the government will try and push their bill to curb council spending through Parliament by Christmas, in time to affect the next 2 years' ILEA budgets. That could mean cuts of £100 million. And, say ILEA, London's steadily rising educational standards would take a sharp knock. Their campaign seeks widespread public support for County Hall's opposition to this government legislation.
Our campaign is about defending educational standards in inner London. What the government appear to want to do through their new proposed bill on local government finance is to force cuts in educational standards in inner London.
But if the government won't pay and you're determined to keep up education standards, then surely once more it's going to be ratepayers who have to make up the shortfall.
Well, at the moment the ratepayer is paying the entire cost of education in inner London. The government took away their grant of £125 million. In those circumstances, we had to ask for that money from the ratepayer. Next year, we could defend our standards, we could keep our standard in our schools by only increasing rates in line with inflation, broadly in line with inflation. We would think that that was reasonable. But what the government are looking for is cuts in our expenditure, which means cuts in standards.
The authority spends two-thirds of its budget on staff, and they say further cuts will mean fewer teachers and class sizes will inevitably grow. Books and equipment could be rationed, and it's in educational areas in which London leads the country that cuts would be felt most heavily. Music and the arts, for example. And it's not just primary and secondary schools that would be affected. Nursery education, neglected for so many years, would have to be cut back. 25% of all adult education in the country is centred in inner London. Schools and education centres are filled every evening with adults taking classes in everything from upholstery to Chinese cookery. And the elderly benefit most. They pay just £1 a year for their classes. That would all have to stop if the new bill became law. But the ILEA is confident that their campaign will gain widespread support, and they're planning to hold a mass lobby of Parliament next month. Jane Corbyn for Thames News.